considering we need to start our descent at 90 nautical miles from destination, so that's just about 40 nautical miles from here, the actual distance to go to the VOR here, the actual final VOR of our route, is only 80. So in 40 nautical miles to SHL, we can also consider that as a descent point. At which point I shall then bring up the arrival path, the actual standard arrival. Currently cruising flight level 390, which is between optimum and max. That's good. We're just using the standard altitude hold here, not the VNAV. For no reason at all. The computer's recommending 0.848, so I'll just drop that one. So 20 miles to go till we have to begin our descent. I'll set up the arrival for the descent page, because right now there's nothing in it. So the arrival is going to be the IGS 13. Just keep that ready for in a moment once we start going down. 4 miles. So we'll just set up the altitude here. So we'll have an initial descent down to flight 280. Vertical speed, and we'll just begin a very gentle descent of 500 feet per minute. And we'll just let the IGS-13 approach. So after SHL, I don't want to go directly to this hold directly, so I'll be modifying that arrival intercept in due course. So at the moment the path is saying do a right, and then all this complicated mess over here, but of course we won't be following that, we're going to be intercepting it on a different angle. So I still want my heading of 125 degrees. So I shall just go over to heading hold, which is going to keep the wings level, which is not going to change our course at all, we're still straight head on to Sierra Hotel Lima. Once we get to there in 30 nautical miles, I'll press heading, we'll take a heading of 125, which will just keep us to the north and bring us a little bit to the east of the airport, and then we'll do a turn to intercept the actual hold, and we'll be around 8 to 10,000 feet as per the approach plate. Now this number here is the descent profile, that's telling us what altitude we are too high, so we're actually, according to this, approaching 5,000 feet too high. If we are to follow the actual route in the flight management computer, but of course we're going to be extending our path, so we can completely ignore this. This is what the computer would be doing if it were actually flying in VNAV mode right now. That's 1,000 feet per minute. Let's have a look at the VNAV descent page. This is saying descend at 0.848 until 287 knots. So we are descending at 0.848. And we should be maintaining 0.848 until we have an indicated airspeed, which is increasing as we descend at 287. Now I can change that as and when I wish, so I could keep that going up to 300 or so knots, but I'll keep it quite low because we've got some big turns coming and we're quite relatively in close proximity to the airport, so I will stick to the recommendation of 287. So just watching the airspeed there. Once I get 287 on the indicated airspeed, I'll switch over to select 287 and I'll go on with flight level change so the computer can keep us descending at the optimum descent rate. There's our green arc telling us that we'll be at 28,000 in 48-50 miles or so. Well, just over 50 miles actually. We'll continue to descend now to flight level 220. Seven coming up. Get ready to change. And 7 miles to go until we take a heading of 125 degrees. That's basic there. 287, flight level change. That's going to bring our power back to idle and increase our rate of descent to maintain, or adjust the pitch of the nose to maintain 287 knots with power at flight idle. So that's going to balance itself out for a nice descent rate. We'll see what that is in a minute when it's ready. And we'll just pass the VOR there, so we'll just take a heading of 125 degrees. Just bring this window down so we can see a bit more. And now we don't need the ICAS page anymore because we're actually in the final, as you might have understood by now, the phase of the four phases of the fuel management control, so I can close this window now. We don't need any ICAS up at all. And I shall bring this one up for a bit more analysis. So what we can see here is the hold here, and then this is the approach of leaving to runway 13. So we're going to be swinging around the airport to this hold here. Now, the name of that is CH, and hold that CH. Now I want to intercept that VOR coming from the east to the west. Now if we look at the map, we're currently up here at the north somewhere, and I want to come around here and intercept, and we'll start holding around here. So let's say I could intercept, rather than 270 this way, so 265 would be this way, so I think perhaps 265. Maybe 260 would be a. It wouldn't be taking us anywhere near the airport. 260 would sort of be like this, which is nowhere near the airport. So we'll say 260. So I shall enable that. That we got. That's our line that we want. So that's our intercept to the actual VOR. Heading at 260, which takes us just to the south of the airport, but doesn't get us too close. So flight idle giving us a descent rate of 1,700 to hold 287 knots. So at the current weight, we're being given 148 as our final approach speed. 30 degrees of flaps, we'll most likely be using that, but I'll set it a bit later because it might drop down a knot as we get a little bit lighter later on. Just picked up the ILS frequency there, but we don't have a distance quite yet. Zoom in. So we're relatively parallel to the runway now. Very nice arrival. Now we're getting a bit closer now, so we'll just continue the descent now to 130, let's say. Initially. It's telling us it's going to be about 40 nautical miles to get down to 13,000, but we want to go to 8, remember? So I'll put 8,000 here, and it's saying that we'll be there in about 50 or so nautical miles. Now 57 nautical miles is here, so at the current descent rate we'll probably be hitting that VOR spot on what we need to be, about 8,000. I'm quite happy with that. I'll just extend this leg a little bit further and intercept at the last possible moment, and we'll fly in with the LNAV enabled, so I'll come into an intercept angle. I'll come in at an intercept angle rather. And then the LNAV can take over rather than do the heading myself to intercept. So test. We've got 10, well, about 13 nautical miles to go, so we don't need to turn just yet. Now you can see that earlier on we were 5,000 feet too high. Now it's telling us, because we're not paying any attention to the actual vertical profile, the descent profile, it's now telling us that we're nearly 4,000 feet too low. So you can see that that's really not important when you know what you're doing with other routing. Of course, that doesn't know that we need to be at 8,000 at VOR. That's assuming ground level. So we're about 8 nautical miles now, so I'll start the right turn to intercept. We'll say intercept about 2:30 with a gentle bank, and we'll see how that line takes us. So we can see that we could bank a little bit more, so we will. And we're approaching 18,000, so we'll think about turning on the seat belts anytime soon. Go into local pressure setting. So I'm going to go ahead and press LNAV now. Now LNAV has engaged. It's considered itself able to intercept at the current bank angle, so that's good. Just approaching 18,000 now to regional pressure. Go and just looking for the coast, we can't see anything yet. So, a nice big turn to intercept, that was perfect. I'm now going to take over vertical speed, just bring up the nose a little bit and allow the speed to come back now to 250 knots. So, I'm now controlling vertical speed. So just overshot a tiny little bit on that magenta line, but that's absolutely no problem at all. I'll now set this up to be on the intercept heading, which is 260, but of course we need to just backtrack a little bit onto that, so I guess I'll keep that on 260 for the intercept heading. The LNAV should be okay. Go ahead and put seatbelts on now. And we're approaching 10,000, so we're going to the outboard landing lights on. And if you have a look at our final approach speed recommendation, still 148, so we'll go and select 148 at 30 degrees. That gives us our V speeds for the flaps. Now we're going to be holding here, so the hold page is set up automatically, but we need to look at the chart. What does it say? Of course, I have the bigger chart, but I've just cut this down to size. It's saying a 270 leg, and I remember from looking that they are 1 minute left turns, so each leg lasts 1 minute. So we have 270 inbound course, perfect, left turn, leg time I remember is 1 minute. So you can have a leg distance or a leg time, and I remember from looking at the chart that it was 1 minute, so I shall execute that. So this hold page is actually quite easy to use. Once you've pressed hold, normally this would, well, if I press next hold, you'll see, I just enter a hold in here, and that takes me to the actual hold page, and you can just simply set your inbound course, left or right turn, leg time or leg distance. Best speed, this is recommending at 233. If you try to change, it will not let you because it recommends the speed. So this is going to change to hold at once we enter the hold. I don't need to change that page myself. So we have to be entering at 8,000, and if we look at the green arc here, the banana, that will be easily possible. And because we're a little bit fast, not a problem, but we're a little bit fast, we can still just bring up the nose a bit and still probably arrive at 8,000. Along with the ability to lose speed as well.